complaining about nothing. She's the one that's complaining. It's a nuisance call. Every time we come home and we have to listen to that, we have to fence ourselves in, block ourselves into the house. We hear the kid inside the house at night, in the daytime.
He's not out there at night.
When he's out in the cold, when he's out in the mud.
And you called CPS on her and they said that
It's not fine. It wasn't fine. The police that was over here saw what was going on.
Okay.
But when he reported it to the Child Protective Services, they couldn't do nothing about it.
Correct.
Because none of their people were here witnessing what she does on a daily basis.
What, lets her kid play
in
the yard?
Yeah, that's all we
it's
do.
Not, there you go again. It's not just as simple as playing in the yard.
Okay.
She's using the kid as a weapon to destroy our peace.
I don't even know you guys.
Absolutely. Okay. And when I met 2 years, let me hear it. 2 years ago, when I told her the way you take care of an autistic child is you put him in a facility.
He doesn't have any kids.
And I help them build a shed that would have all the things that the kid needs: heat in the winter, cold in the summer, the water, tiled windows, so that he couldn't escape. This child
is
off of the
property.
Not in months. I've got videos of the kid running around on my property. Okay, and she was in her room on the phone that we couldn't even bang on the door loud enough that she would even come to the door to find out where her kid is. The kid has also escaped across the street naked, that woman, Kathy, across the street neighbor, had to find where the kid was.
He wasn't naked.
All right, but you've already reported all of that.
Yes.
And so when is she going to take the responsibility as a mother?
I'm not doing anything wrong.
To keep the child safe.
Can I tell you?
Go ahead.
Okay, so you reported all of that to CPS, and they found nothing for her open investigation. Okay?
That doesn't mean it's right.
I'm not saying it's right or wrong, but that's what the child's doing right now is, there's nothing we can do about it. He's not breaking any laws. He's in an English.
Who says anything about the kid breaking laws?
I'm just saying. But
when the kid's
what would you like us to do? How would you like it? She's not going to put her own.
You are having a child. You don't leave him outside where your neighbors are constantly, every day, being bothered by the noises that the kid makes.
Okay. So when would you prefer the child to be outside?
When we're not here.
Okay. Well, the world doesn't revolve around.
Okay. Now that was just a sarcastic answer.
Correct.
Okay.
That was.
Because that is the attitude that she takes every day by using this kid as a weapon.
But you. All right. Let me just dumb it down. So you have your own property, correct? And she has her own property.
This ain't going to work.
All right. Well, right. But you have freedoms on your property.
Here's
correct?
The solution.
And she has freedoms on
the
her property.
The solution is that an autistic should build.
Why would she put her autistic kid in a facility?
Because that, when you go on the autistic child.
Oh, you mean
sites,
like build something out back?
A shed.
Oh, okay.
You see like that right there?
Yes.
A shed like that is a facility that the kid could be in and to be safe, couldn't escape from. Also, would be cool in the summer, hot in the evening.
But you do realize we can't make her build that, right?
That's no. When I suggested that with her father-in-law,
okay,
was on the phone. I talked to him about it first, and he agreed with me that that was what should have been done. He was even willing to pay for it, okay? And the mother-in-law was also in agreement. Now, when I came here the very next day and told her about it, she was obstinate, narrow-minded, and walked away from the conversation.
Well, yeah, but I understand where you're coming from, because, like, you're hoping that's what happens, but like she doesn't have to do it.
A responsible person of an autistic child would understand that that's the most amount of sense that you could possibly make out of the situation. Not putting up barbed wire that a kid is
there's no barbed wire you can
strangle himself with it, and then put a plastic. I don't understand how the plastic is stopping the noise that the kid's making.
It's trying to keep you from seeing him.
Seeing it.
Seeing him,
it's
yes.
not a matter of seeing
it's
it.
It's his privacy.
It's a matter of the noise. And you didn't get that fact from the very first time we mentioned it to you.
Possibly you haven't done anything with your property to make it better.
This is the problem you have,
Erica. No, you're with the problem.
No,
this is your problem.
You've made more
nuisance calls. If it was my problem, it would have been fixed. But it's yours.
But your wife just came into the district. I've talked to her.
So what?
I'm
she's
just
supposed
saying,
to. She. We're taxpayers here. We deserve peace and quiet too.
I'm taxpayers.
Yeah. She's a renter.
Okay.
You don't think my husband's going to inherit this property?
Who cares?
It's his property.
He's not inheriting it now. Oh. And you told your mother-in-law, who owns the property, you told
to do whatever he wants us to do.
You told the owner of the property to go screw themselves. And you were going to do what you wanted to do, not what they wanted to do.
Let's not continue to argue. So what would be the solution to this issue?
The solution would be have her talk some sense into her and do the right thing by the child. Don't keep the child in the elements and destroying the child's welfare.
Actually, he's very happy. You can hear him.
Neighbor's peace of mind.
Okay. He's happy. You can hear him.
I just know from my experience.
He's not happy.
He's very happy.
You listen to him moan every day.
You don't know anything about autism.
Autistic kids, you know they have to stimulate themselves. And being inside is not good for them.
Stimulation, okay, comes in many forms.
Okay.
And the hose that he's actually playing with right now.
I don't care.
It was my suggestion 2 years ago. Okay? Now, the thing is that when he graduates into becoming more of a noise nuisance, mm-hmm. it's not black plastic that's going to solve the problem. And as the kid gets older, and he does the things that he can do as an autistic child,
right.
it's going to become a bigger and bigger problem.
Okay, but
you can't have a 16 and 17 year old child standing around masturbating and making noises like this in the neighborhood
where
everybody
can masturbate.
Well, what do you think he's going to do?
So he's never
mastered. Did you read the section on autistic children that they actually exactly what monkeys do, primates do? And one of those things are masturbating and throwing their feces and doing other things like moaning like he does. Now, these are the things that we're concerned about.
Okay, but and that, when we has bring, any of that stuff happened yet?
Well, it's happened before.
Like what?
We've heard him making sexual sounds.
Like what?
Like as if he was masturbating. Now, I don't know if that's what he's doing.
Okay.
But the fact
so you've never seen it, but you think that's what happened.
Well, look, we can't come over here and make accusations.
Right.
I'm just telling you what we're hearing.
So I'm just trying to figure this, because this is an ongoing issue for over like a year now.
3 years.
Well, we've only been like...
Well, that's because we tolerated it for the first year and a half, 2 years.
So what can we do for you guys?
I don't know. Explain to her that cooperating with her neighbors, like I was cooperating with her in the beginning, is a good idea. Only she wants to do.
I got you. No big deal.
And Scott is in the middle of it all. He's not equipped to actually do anything about the situation because she controls him like she controls all the animals
I have a lot
and
of power.
The children on the wow. property.
All right. I have a lot of power
well,
here.
I'll talk to them. We'll go from there, okay? There's really... The sheriff's office is like their hands are tied. This is on their property. He's not breaking any...
All right. Is there a thing called nuisance calling?
Right. Yes. Okay.
Explain to her what nuisance calling is.
It could be a noise ordinance, but that what he's doing is not a noise ordinance.
I'm not talking about the noise ordinance against what we're hearing. I'm talking about her calling the cops on us when we try to explain to her that she should be doing
Your
the right thing.
Your wife is not talking to me.
Child.
She's screaming and
okay,
yelling.
So you can go downtown and try to get an injunction. Which
oh,
I'll,
please
I'll,
do it. Do it.
I will literally...
Oh, my God.
I'll
be so happy.
Both you guys can go...
Please
go,
get an injunction.
Go, all right. Let me talk. Both of you guys can don't go downtown to the courthouse. Do you know where the courthouse is?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, you go downtown and you get trial.
It is? You want to go to court?
I know that. I
get an injunction?
But it's not going to solve the issue. But I'm just trying to give him options.
Erica,
you know what I'm saying?
You are really...
You can say whatever you want,
you're in a bad place mentally.
No, you're the one making these weird accusations. You don't even know about my child.
I know everything about everything that you've done.
You think you know.
Right. I was the one that signed the papers that made it allowing that you could be here in the first place. Do you remember that?
No, that didn't matter.
This is my parents' place.
The fact of the matter is that I work with her. I cooperate with her.
Why don't you guys move?
Everything
is a good
thing.
If you're so unhappy, why don't you move?
But she does nothing in return. She doesn't even consider me.
That's because of you.
Yeah, that's because of you.
That is not what I told her to build.
No, you...
I told you what to build.
No, you didn't. You don't want him over
there.
You don't
and when he doesn't
there.
Go over there.
That takes care
of it. The day that they finished it, he was on my property.
He hasn't come over there in months.
The
yeah,
day he finished it,
he
escaped.
The gate.
I'm going to tell you something. I gave you the solution. I told you.
No.
Take a shed and equip the shed to keep your kid in a safe place.
I've explained the rights that you have. Right. I explained their rights.
Uh-huh.
There's really, our hands are tied.
This is not rights. This is making the person understand that she has a responsibility as an autistic mother
Which
to be
is not
doing
your
things
problem.
Better than that. That's not better.
And I've explained
that's
to you,
problem.
Like they're allowed to parent
that's
however
not
they
my
want.
Problem. It's your problem.
It's not your problem.
I've explained to you,
it's
they
not.
Can parent however they want. As Child Protective Services has been over here
yes.
and investigated them.
Yes.
That's their prelim. You can CPS
education.
Is definitely going to be able to call, or they're going to be able to make contact with a child, because the child probably goes to school, so.
Yes.
We can't make contact either, but when he's on my property,
well,
we got to herd him away.
That is
the
only time we could do something, if that child is on your property, okay?
When's the last time he was on your property?
Now, What is the responsible thing to that response that you just said? Why is she buried in a room thumbing her phone when the child that she's supposed to be supervising
is out running around all over the neighborhood? We have cameras. We have cameras everywhere.
He's in there.
I got you. Listen.
The thing is, you need to educate yourself about how to bring up an autistic child and yourself.
All right. All right. Go back inside. I'm going to let them go back inside. All right.